Hello, this is part of a short series on how to turn a 3D model into a functional VTuber avatar. So this is part 2, which will focus on what you need to do within Unity. So first, we must export our model as FBX. So select your skeleton and also your model, and then go to File, Export.fbx. And then here you can see the settings that I usually use, which work. So you can pause the video or take a screenshot to copy them. And then make sure you have a name that you like. Then click on Export FBX. Then you go to these GitHub repositories to obtain these Unity packages. So UniVRM, VCFace SDK, and Poiyomi Toon Shader. The links will be in the description down below. So this will let you add the functionality to your model so that it will work correctly as an avatar. Okay, the Poiyomi Toon Shader is technically not necessary, but it is a very good and customizable shader that will work well with VCFace. So I will walk through the process of making the whole Unity project to exporting the model from scratch. So as you can see here, we are in the Unity Hub, which you should already have if you have already downloaded Unity. And then we can go create a new project by pressing New. And then we're just going to choose 3D. And we can give it a name. I'm just going to call this VCFace example. And then we press Create. And Unity is just going to create a project for us. Note that when downloading these packages, you should go and read the release notes, because sometimes they will state something like this supports Unity 2020.3 LTS or later. And then you want to make sure that whatever Unity version you created the project on, it must be this or later. Because then you can make sure that there will be no problems with compatibility. So to do that, you can click the arrow here and then make sure that you have got the right version here. So for example, 2020.3, so click that, and then you can create a new project with that Unity version. So that's how you make sure that everything will work correctly. If you cannot find a suitable Unity version after pressing this triangle, or there is no triangle, you can come down to Installs and then see if you got a suitable Unity version installed here. If not, then you can press Add so that you can download a new version. Okay, so here we are going to import our packages. So first, come to Assets, Import Package, then select Custom Package. After that, you can navigate to wherever you have stored your packages. So right here, I've got my packages, and then we'll do UniVRM first. So it's going to give you this dialog box. Just press All, and then Import. And then here you will see that it pops up this dialog box, says recommended project settings. Let's just use recommended. And then you can close the window. So that's UniVRM done. Now let's move on to import custom package. Let's move on to VSF SDK. This is also going to take a while, so press All, Import. Okay, I suppose that's done. Now let's just move on to the shader, Poiyomi. There. Press All, Import. And And that is done. Good. So congratulations, you have now successfully set up your Unity project for preparing to import your character. Okay, so now it's time to go and import our FBX file. So first we're just going to create a folder for that. Let's just call it my character. Good enough. Now go to where you've got your FBX file stored. Then just drag it in. And then as you can see, it appears in the project folder structure. And then you can drag it into the hierarchy, which is this window over here, so that you can preview it in the world. To control the camera, just hold right mouse button and then use WASD to move around. Okay, so we are going to start setting up our character. So click on whatever file you have imported into here, and then go to Model. Press Legacy Blend Shape Normals. That's just going to keep the shading from looking weird once the blend shapes we have set kick in. And then go to Rig, Humanoid, and Apply. Wait for that to load, then press Configure. So there are two bones you need to keep track of here. First go to Body, Chest, and then you want to make sure there's a bone here. So we'll just use the chest bone. Go over to the hierarchy window here, then drag it over to this box, and that is set. We don't need the upper chest part. And then for head, we did not set a jawbone, we did not use that system, so we'll just click here and then press backspace, and that's just going to remove the jawbone. And then remember to go and hit apply. Wait for it to load, and then press done. And now we have set up the rig part. Now we are going to go and put materials. So we're just going to use external materials. Press apply. And it's going to give a folder full of all the materials that your character uses. It actually takes some time to fine tune all the materials, so I'll just show you the basics. So materials, these are already set to this character. You can preview them on this character. So first of all, go to shader. Normally it's standard, but you can choose the shaders that we have installed, which is Poiyomi. And then go to Poiyomi 8.0. That is currently the newest version. And then I usually just use Poiyomi Tune. And now that's gonna work. So, but we still need the textures. So just go to a folder that you have your textures, select all, and then drag them into Unity. Now that we have those, we can go over to color and normals. So here's color and alpha. Usually you want to set this to white, otherwise it's going to tint your texture a certain color. And then you can go and get the texture you have, drag them into this slot that is called texture, and now you have the texture applied to your character. But that's still not good enough because we need the shading. So we can now go over to the shadings tab, shading, and then now it's set to flat, so that means there will be no lighting here, there's no shadows. So we can go and get texture ramp, and then it's going to do this to our character, which looks ugly, so we can go and set the lighting ramp. There's two types of modes here. Blend just means, you know, it's a smooth color blend like this. It's a smooth transition, but usually I use fixed. You can pick your own over here. And then for these little adjustment knobs. You can click on them and then press delete to get rid of them. Or you can left click to make a new one. Double click on any of them to set a new color. And then you will realize that with shading, it actually looks a lot better. Now this is just a very rough example, so it doesn't look quite good, but you can copy this technique for all of the textures you have used, and then you can use this to move back and forth to adjust how much shading you want. So that's the basics of putting shaders using Poiyomi. Of course, there's a lot of other functions, but you can look up the tutorials yourself. I will provide some material in the description down below. So this is what it looks like after I've roughly adjusted the shadings of all of the materials. So congratulations, we have now imported the character, and in the next video, we will start discussing how to actually customize it more and then export it so it can be used in VC Phase.